So inshallah, the one who is giving the lecture won't be disturbed. Jazakumullah khairan. Make sure that if you have a topic, if you have your question, make sure that you write it down. Inshallah. There will be a paper or a book that will be around. So if you have a question, make sure you write it down and make sure that your question goes with the topic that Ustaz is going to talk about. Jazakumullah khairan. Ustaz, Farid Fadl.
Alhamdulillah. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله اللهم صل على رسول الله وبعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for everything. We thank Him for this night. We thank Him for the ni'mah of Islam. We thank Him subhanahu wa ta'ala for the ni'mah of health. We pray that He protect us and He make things easy for us. Alhamdulillah, as you heard, we gathered here today for the sake of Allah, in the way of Allah, to advise each other about Allah. So, this message I am going to give it a name. The reminder of love. Because whatever you are going to hear from me tonight is from my heart. So I will be talking to you from my heart. Why? Because of love. So the topic is the reminder of love. The love of Allah. The love of His Messenger, the love of the parents, the love of the children, and the love of our religion. I pray, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make His giving. So before I start, the first thing I would like to remind all of you is at this moment, we are sitting right here, and Allah invites you to Jannah. Will you go? Will you go? May Allah make this easy. So let's all go to Allah. I'm not saying to die, I say to go to Jannah. So let's all go to Allah. Let's all go to Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. Run to Allah. Fly to Allah. Do not fly from Him, but fly to Him. Go to Him. So in everything you are going to do in life, make sure you are with Allah. Because Allah إِنَّ حِزْبَ اللَّهِ هُمُ. Somebody complete it. Allah إِنَّ حِزْبَ اللَّهِ هُمُ. مفلحون and هم الفائزون also, right? Good. So inshallah we are going to talk about first the rights of parents upon their children, and inshallah in our next meeting we will also talk about the rights of the children upon their parents. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gave everybody rights. Okay? The parents have rights upon their children, and the children also have rights upon their parents. And inshallah, we pray, may Allah make it so, we will do justice to these topics. May Allah make this easy. But it's urgent that we added another topic to it, which you heard, inshallah, it will come later after this. Now, I start. My brothers and sisters, if you heard the news, since last week, and this is one of the things that pushed me to encourage this topic to go on, because it was going to be canceled due to, you know, because we had another program like 2 weeks ago or a week ago, and now today we are here again. But it's urgent. That's why I said the message of love, the reminder of love. Wallahi, whatever I will tell you today is from my heart. Last week, 8 days ago, as some of you were aware, we wonderful brother. A wonderful young man. A man of God. He was young, but he achieved a lot in this life due to one thing. And I will tell you why. This is why we got it here. He was 26 years old. He was very young. He was like you. He was healthy. He just finished college. He started his job. He went to Hajj last year. He went and paid for his mom and dad to go to Umrah, and he died 2 days later. He was like you. He was one of you. He was young. But one thing about him that made him special is what we are going to talk about today. I attended the funeral. I went to see the family at the masjid, and we heard all the witnesses and all the things people were saying, the good things people were saying about him. The one that moved me, that I want to talk to you about, is this topic that we are going to talk about today. When it comes to his father and mother, he was wonderful. So now, before I start, I want all of you, each and every one of you, ask yourself right now, ask yourself, if you die at this moment, what are they going to say about you when it comes to your mother and father? Please answer, but keep it to yourself. Answer yourself. The way they were saying good things about him, are they going to say the same thing about you concerning your parents? Are they going to say it? Now, as I said, parents have rights, and the children also have rights, because Allah is just. Allah is just. But we're going to start with the parents first. First, we're going to talk about the mother and the father. Right from the day she conceived you, it was pain, challenges after challenges. After some months, it is back pain, legs, and pain all over her body. Why? Because she is carrying you. If you have ever seen the day a woman is delivering, giving birth to a child, what is happening in that room? Where is she? She doesn't know where she is. And all she is thinking about, maybe I'm not going to make it, but oh Allah, I pray that you make this boy come out safely. Not talking about the sleepless nights. Sometimes she will not sleep. She wants to eat something, but because of you, the doctor said no, she cannot eat it. And she will stop because she wants you to come out right. She wants to sleep. She cannot sleep on the back, on her back, or on her belly. She has to sleep side because of you. And now that you are out, you would think her work would stop right there. But this is the beginning of the work of the mother. Making sure that you eat, you are well fed. Making sure that she clean you very nice. And making sure you get all the things you needed, so that you will grow up and become a responsible human being and healthy. This is mother. And she is doing all this with the support of father. So now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said to us, due to these things that they are going through, or they went through, or they passed through, then we owe them something, which is, listen to Allah in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Baqarah, وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا مِيثَاقَ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ لَا تَعْبُدُونَ إِلَّا اللَّهَ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. The thing I want for you to do to your parents is that Allah said, remember, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took the covenant with the children of Israel, He said to them, do not worship anyone except Allah and be dutiful to your parents. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Be dutiful to your parents. You see, when it comes to the greatest sin is to associate Allah with a partner. So Allah attached this with the obedience of parents. لَا تَعْبُدُونَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Worship none except Allah. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And be good to your parents. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, again, please listen carefully, in Surah Al-Nisa, وَعْبُدُوا اللَّهِ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. And worship Allah and do not associate Him with a partner. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And be nice and be good and be dutiful to your parents. How many ayahs so far?
Two.
Count it for me, count it for me. Let's go to Surah Al-An'am. قل تعالوا أتل ما حرم ربكم عليكم. Say come. As you are all gathered here, come. أتل ما حرم ربكم عليكم. I will recite to you what your Lord has forbidden for you to do. What is it? ألا تعبدوا إلا what? Only worship, do not worship except who?
Allah.
Only Allah. قُلْ تَعَالَوْا أَتْلُ مَا حَرَّمَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَيْكُمْ أَلَّا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Come, let me recite to you what your Lord has forbidden for you to do. أَلَّا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. Do not associate him with a partner. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And be good to your parents. Be dutiful to your parents. How many ayahs so far?
Three.
We have more. Surah Isra.
وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ.
And your Lord has decreed that you should worship none except Allah.
وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا.
And be dutiful to your parents. Before we go further, I will stop here. Be dutiful to your parents. So for how many ayahs? Four ayahs. But let's go down this ayah. Allah said,
إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبَرَ أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا.
قراءات. Three قراءات here. And the meaning of this word is, do not say, did you hear the sound? You hear the sound? Do not say to your mom, do because it's the way the root of this word is from nafkha, okay, to blow. So Allah said, if one of them or both of them grow old, okay, and you are with them, you should not say to them, please, let me ask you a question. How many times you told your mom, leave me alone? Allah said for you not to say, to blow, or she talk, and you feel like, how many times you said, leave me alone? Or how many times you close the door on your mother's face? How many times? How many times? Before I go, I was talking about a brother we buried 8 days ago. I repeat, he was healthy. He was young, full of life, handsome, young, 26 years old, great job. But he slept, he went to sleep, and he did not wake up. He woke up in his grave. He wasn't sick. But when I went to the parents to say salam, what the parents were saying, the witness about him, he was so dutiful to his mother and father. I said, subhanAllah, this message, I have to bring this message here. He was so dutiful to his mother and father. And to prove that to you, I told you he went and paid for his mother and father to go to Umrah, and he died 2 days later. Now, do you have any assurance that if you go to bed tonight, you are going to wake up? Can you come and swear and say, if I sleep tonight, I will wake up? Anybody? Anybody? No one. So we don't know when we are going to die. But listen to me. Listen to me carefully here. This boy, his parents love him so much. Only two of them, his mother had. Him and his younger brother. But Allah took him. And the mother is alive. Allah took him. And the father is alive. He was supposed to get married this summer. The girl he's going to marry is my cousin. He was supposed to marry. She's my cousin. This is life. But one thing, imagine if he was not dutiful to his parents, what are they going to say? And what is going to be his destination? But alhamdulillah, he was so wonderful to his parents, so they witnessed that, they said it, the parents said that, and also people who witnessed the way he treated the parents said that. So please, what are they going to say about you when you die at this moment? So Allah said, in Surah Al-Isra, فَلَا تَقُلْ لَمَا أُفْ. Do not say to them, do not say to them, just like showing them that, oh, come on. This is a common word you say to your moms, you say to your dad. And for those who say, leave me alone, I will tell you where the person is going later. So my brothers and sisters, our parents are very important in our life. And we can never pay them, wallahi. So Allah said for us to be nice to them, to respect them, to treat them nicely, to be dutiful to them, and never, never, never insult them, never say anything that will make them feel pain. How many times you made your mom cry? How many times? Allah said, وَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا. Do not repel them. وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا. If you are going to talk to them, choose beautiful words. The way you approach them, the way you address them. Why? Because we are Muslim. We are human beings. We don't have wings. We don't have wings. But Allah said, وَخْفِضْ لَهُمَا جَنَاحَ الذُّلِّ مِنَ الرَّحْمَةِ. The wings, bring down the wings of submission and humility towards them, to them, whenever you are talking to them. That means, whenever you are in front of them, let them understand that, yes, are your parents and you are their son. And remember, if you do the same, your son will do the same to you. Whatever you do to them, your children will give you the same thing. And my students here, they know, in this masjid, they know my word. I say, if you say to your mom, ah, your son will slap you. If you say to your son, if you say to your mom, leave me alone, huh, your son will drag you out of your house. And I told him, if you want to be homeless when you grow up, disrespect your parents. You will be outside saying, can I have a quarter? Wallahi, this is serious, my brothers and sisters. I told you, whatever you are going to hear from me is from my heart, wallahi. And I call it the message of love, because I love all of you for the sake of Allah. I want us to be saved together. So my brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so far we read how many ayats? 4 ayats. We are in Surah what? Surah Al-Isra. Allah said that we should be nice to them and do not say to them. Now, come to Surah Luqman. First to Surah Al-Ankabut. وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ حُسْنًا. How many? 5. 6. Surah Luqman. وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ وَهْنًا عَلَى وَهْنٍ وَفِصَالُهُ فِي عَامَيْنِ أَنِ اشْكُرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيْكَ إِلَيَّ الْمَصِيرُ. Listen to this ayah, please carefully. Allah said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is advising you to take good care of your parents. Why? حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ وَهْنًا عَلَى وَهْنٍ. Look, when she conceived you, it was hardship after hardship. Hardship upon hardship. So Allah said, أَنِشْكُرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيْكَ. Thank me, Allah, and thank your parents. How do you thank your mother? How do you say thank you to your mother? By obeying your mother. How do you say thank you to your father? By obeying your father. And if you say no, you are not going to obey your mother and father, listen to Allah. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Jannatu tahta aqdami al-ummahat. The paradise is under the feet of our parents. Now, you may ask me, okay, what is the benefit? What am I going to get if I do all this to my mother, to my father? I'm going to give you only one benefit, only one. And this benefit is better than all the benefits you will think about. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if you remember, he said to be what? Good to them. Ihsan. To be good and dutiful to them. Listen. Can I ask you a question? Is there any love better than the love of Allah? Please. If Allah will say, I love you, is there any love better than that? No. But Allah is promising you that if you do that to your parents, He will love you. Please, even because only this, would you strive and take good care and respect your parents just to earn the love of Allah? Just to earn the love of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Imran, الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء والكاظمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين. He said he loves you. He loves you. By obeying your mother, by obeying your father, he said he loves you due to that. Surah Al-Imran. فآتاهم الله ثواب الدنيا وحسن ثواب الآخرة والله يحب المحسنين. He loves you. Why? Because you obey your mother and father. سورة المائدة فبما نقضهم ميثاقهم لعناهم وجعلنا قلوبهم قاسية يحرفون الكلمة عن مواضعه ونسوا حظا مما ذكروا به ولا تزال تطلع على خائنة منهم إلا قليلا منهم فاعف عنهم واصفح إن الله يحب المحسنين. He loves them. إن الله يحب المحسنين. So being nice, good, respecting your mother, respecting your father, you will earn the love of Allah. And I told you, there is no love better than that. And let me give you this hadith of the Messenger of Allah narrated by Abu Hurairah. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ إِذَا أَحَبَّ عَبْدًا دَعَ جِبْرِيلٍ. When Allah loves His parents, His servants, da'a Jibreel, he will call Jibreel. Inni uhibbu fulanan fa'ahibba. I love so and so, I want you to love him. And Jibreel will love the person. And Jibreel will announce the dwellers of heaven. Inna Allaha yuhibbu fulanan fa'ahibbu. Allah loves so and so, so love him. All the angels will love you. ثم يوضع له القبول في الأرض. And then Allah will send this love all the way down. If people see you, they love you. Why? Because it's a sign of the love of Allah on you. Where did you get this from? From obeying the mother and father. So the Messenger of Allah said, رضا الله. The pleasure of Allah is in the pleasure of the parents. And the displeasure of Allah is in the displeasure of the parents. Meaning, if your mother is happy with you, Allah is happy with you. If your mother is angry, then Allah also is angry at you. Allah is angry with you. Please, can I ask you a question? الأرض أرضه. The earth is his. والسماء سماؤه. And the sky, the heaven is his. Where else can you go? If the owner of these two things say, I don't like you, where else will you get success in life? You are very important in life. You are our future in life. You are our future, that without you, we are nothing. So all we want, all the parents want, the advice we are giving you is that please obey and you will be blessed by Allah. It will be very painful one day to see, a'udhu billah, one of you on the streets. A'udhu billah, doing drugs. A'udhu billah, asking people for quarters outside. And if you say no to your parents, you disrespect them. Believe me, if they don't forgive you, you will find yourself in this kind of situation. So their rights is that you should be kind, you should be respectful, you should be dutiful to them. Always say yes to them, obey them. Why? And always remember, I am obeying you because of Allah. And I am obeying you because I want to be blessed by Allah. So yes to you, and you will be blessed. And now, remember, you will also grow one day. You will get married very soon. I pray may Allah give the girls good husbands. Say Ameen. MashaAllah. The brothers are not going to pray for them till later. You will have your children one day. Now I want you to think, the way I'm treating my mother, what I say to my mother, if my son or daughter should say that to me, how will I feel? How will I feel? Please ask yourself. The way I'm treating my mother, the way I talk to my mother, the way I approach my mother, telling her, leave me alone, I'm not going to do it. Leave me alone. Yeah, I'm not going to do it. Your son say the same thing to you, how will you feel? But I'm telling you, is buy one, get one free. If you say one to your mom, your son will give you two. Your son will give you two. And I said, this will give you the anger. Allah will be angry. Why? Because your mom is not happy with you. Let me give you this story. It's a poem, a brother wrote. A woman, a young man, nice, he was good. Then he joined bad company. They start stealing stuff. Now they sent him to his house to go and steal his mom's belongings. When he went to the house, he was drunk. He was doing drugs. So when he went, the mom tried to stop him. He stabbed his mother. Please listen to the love of mother. He stabbed the mother many times, and she was bleeding. He was running away, and he turned. He looked. What did I do? This is my mom. I just stabbed. Then he started shaking. He was shaking like this. He took the same knife. He was going to stab him, his chest, to kill himself. Why? Because he just killed his mother. You know what she said? Listen to the word of her mother. She said, my son, stop. Do not stab me twice. Who was he going to stab? The second one? Himself. But she said, no, stop. Do not stab me twice. What you did is enough. Do not add another one. Who will do this if it's not mother? Please, who will do this if it's not mother? Who? You stab her. She is dying. You're about to stab yourself. She tell you to stop? This is the love of mother. She loves you. Your dad loves you. Believe me, they have no one better than you. And they want you to become responsible people in future. That's why. Do not do this. Do not go this way. Why did you do that? Please do it this way. Why? Because he wants to be proud of you in future. That's why. Otherwise, there is no need of doing that. It's not about controlling. Oh, I'm grown now. And one thing, no matter how old you are still your mom's daughter. No matter how old you think you are, you are still your mom's son. You will never stop being their son. You are their son. You are their daughter. So please obey them. Respect them. Never say to them. And please, from this night, starting today, if you understand what I'm saying, I'm going to send give you a message. May Allah bless all of you. We made mistakes. Yes, we did. We pray, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. But now, please, all of you, all those listening to me now, I beg you in the name of Allah, please. Wallahi, I'm talking to you right now, I'm shaking, my legs, I'm shaking. You know why? Because I do this all the time. And some of my students over here, they already know what I'm going to say. Please, 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 tonight when you go home, ask your mom to forgive you. Please do that. Wallahi, I do that all the time. Every Friday, before I come up, I come from my house to climb on this minbar, I call my mother and say, please forgive me. She said, but you didn't do. I said, yes, I still want you to forgive me and bless me. Wallahi, their prayers is very quick. When they pray for you, it is very quick. Allah accept it fast. Try it. Try it. It works. Because I'm trying it, I'm doing it every day, and it's working for me. Please try it. Tonight, please. I know you are fine, baby, now with your mom or with your dad, but please, when you go, please say, please, mommy, forgive me. Please forgive me. Let me give you this two stories about Ibn Umar and Ibn Abbas. Ibn Umar, he saw a man going around the Kaaba with a woman on his back. He said to Ibn Umar, Ibn Umar, you see, this is my mother behind my back. I am her mount. I am her camel. I go down, she climb on me. I come down, she gets down. I do everything for her. You think I paid her? He said, you haven't done a thing. Not yet. He said, you can never pay her. All this thing that you think you are doing, not even 1%. Not even 1%. And another man, he came to Ibn Abbas. He said, Yabna Ammi Rasulillah. I was trying to talk to a woman to marry me, but she said no. When she said no, I said okay. But another man came and she accepted him. So I said, no way. I killed her. He said, you did what? He said, I killed her. But now, I realize it was wrong. Will Allah forgive me? Listen to this. Will Allah forgive me? Ibn Abbas was so quiet. And he said, is your mom alive? Then his students asked, he killed somebody, asking, is his mom alive? He said, you know why? I don't know any good deeds that Allah accepts quick and forgives sin like being dutiful to your mother. If she was alive, I was going to tell him, go and be nice to your mother. Allah will forgive you. This is the power of obedience and respectful and being obedient to the mother and father. So please, for the sake of Allah, if you go tonight, say, please, mommy, mean it. Please forgive me and pray for me. Please, how many people will do it? If you do it, please raise your hand. Yeah. Should I continue? Alhamdulillah. Please, remember that. When you go, say forgive me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of you. So now, if you do that, and you die at this moment, and we carry you to the grave, to that narrow hole, inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have mercy on your soul. Death is true. We will all die one day. We can never run away from death. Today I was telling my students, some people say there is no God because they are out of their mind, but they never say there is no death. Never. No matter how crazy they are saying there is no God, they will never say there is no death. Because when they say that, that means they are out of it. So remember, please be dutiful to your parents. It is very important. So their rights, be nice. Their rights, be dutiful. Be respectful. Their rights, never make them angry. Their rights, never insult them. Their rights, never do anything that will make them cry. And that is the worst. When they are going to cry, let them cry due to happiness because of your success, your achievement, your obedience, not because you cause them pain. And if you make them cry because of pain, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will start punishing you. And one thing about disobeying parents, please listen. Allah is not going to wait until you go to Qiyamah. No, Allah starts punishing you from here. That's the danger of it. You see, this, okay, until we go to... No, here you will start receiving the punishment from here. You will see that you go to class. Look, the professor will come and talk and talk and talk. I don't get it. Believe me, sometimes the secret is with the mother. Go and say, please forgive me and see something. Don't try. I told you from the beginning, whatever I'm telling you is from my heart, wallahi. Sometimes you don't understand things in school. You come, they talk and talk and talk. The professor will talk, the teacher will talk. Your friend will get it. And you say, I don't get it. And you will be sleeping in the class because you don't understand the topic. Please respect your mother. Go and tell your mom to forgive you and see something. And my proof is in the Quran. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهِ. If you have the fear of Allah, Allah said, He will teach you. He will become your teacher. May Allah forgive us all. Now, I will move to the second item, and this is going to take us maybe in 20 minutes, 15 minutes, inshallah, we go home. We know what's going on. Most of you go to college, some of you high school. All you hear is Muslims are bad. You hear something happen, they say he's a Muslim. And I know sometimes you are confused. Mostly, you know, the little ones. Okay, why all these people doing this and they are calling them Muslim? So my religion is preaching to people to go and cause harm to the others? No. No. This is not our religion. The message I have for you today, this topic that we treated, the first one, is enough. But I would like to remind you, because most of you are going back to school on Thursday. I want to make this reminder so that we will understand to know how to educate and how to appear and how to answer, how to receive whenever the ignorance address us, on how to address them, on how to respond. Because sometimes it's painful. Sometimes even the teachers do it. Sometimes even the teachers, the professors, you will sit down, you see, they will be throwing punches at you. Okay? You cannot do something, you don't want to talk. But listen to me. We have to prove to people that we are peaceful. First, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our creator, He is As-Salam. He is what? As-Salam. Among the attributes of Allah is what? As-Salam. What is As-Salam? The only source of peace. The only one who gives peace, Allah. Allah said in Surah Al-Hashr, هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام. So among the name of Allah is what? Peace. So Allah is the only one who gives peace. So Allah said, Wallahu yad'u ila dari salam. And Allah is calling you to the house of what? Peace.
Peace. And our messenger, Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's the messenger. He is a symbol. He is a message of peace. We have to educate people. We have to let them know that we are peaceful and this is our religion. Whatever is happening somewhere, those people are not representing us because we are Muslim. When we are the followers of the Prophet Muhammad, listen to the Prophet Muhammad. The first time he entered Medina, please listen carefully. He said, Ya ayyuhan nas, all people, afshu salam, spread the greetings of peace. Afshu salam, spread the greetings of peace. Wa at'imu at'am, and feed the poor. Wa sallu bil layli wan nas niyam, and pray during the night while people are praying. Tadkhulul jannata bi salam, you will enter paradise in peace. The first thing he said, what? Spread what? Peace. Because when you say to someone assalamu alaikum, the meaning is I will never hurt you. I will never hurt you. I will never cause you pain. So the Messenger of Allah said, the Messenger of Allah said, Afshu salam, that we should spread peace. Please, when he said, Ya ayyuhan nas, is he talking to only Muslim? Are we the only people? No. Ya ayyuhan nas, the whole mankind. That's why. You guys ever heard of Mahatma Gandhi? You heard about him, right? When he read the biography of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know what he said? He said, "Innahu bila munaza yamliku quluba malayin al-bashar." He said, he uncontested. He said, Muhammad, he said, he uncontested won the hearts of millions of people due to what? Due to peace. Due to peace. Mahatma Gandhi, was he a Muslim? No. But he spoke the truth. So one of the messages of the Prophet Muhammad is, Irhamu man fil ardi, have mercy on those on the surface of the earth, and the one in heaven will have mercy on you. This is the message of Islam. So the message of Islam was what? Is what? Peace. The message of Islam is peace. If you remember, during our last program, we said all the messengers were Muslim. You remember that? You know why? They were peaceful because they were all Muslims. How? What is the meaning of al-Islam? It is derived from the root, Arabic root, Salima, peace. So a Muslim is someone who submits entirely to the will of Allah. To the will of Allah. So all the messengers and the prophets, we said they were what? Muslim. You remember? Some of you were not here. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Yunus, فَإِن تَوَلَّيْتُمْ فَمَا سَأَلْتُمْ عَلَيْهِ مِنْ أَجْرٍ إِنْ أَجْرَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَأُمِرْتُ أَنْ أَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. So Prophet Nuh, he came with peace, as we said, because he was a what? Please complete for me. Nuh alayhi salam, he came with peace because he was what? Muslim. إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. So he was peaceful because he came with what?
Islam.
He came with what?
Islam.
Yaqub, Ismail, Ishaq, they were peaceful and they came with peace. They addressed people peace and they promoted peace because they were Muslim. Am kuntum shuhada idh hadara Yaqub al-maut idh qala li banihi ma ta'buduna min ba'di qalu na'budu ilahaka wa ilaha abaika Ibrahim wa Ismaila وإسحاق إلها واحدا ونحن له we are peace givers. So they were Muslim, they came with peace because they were Muslim. يوسف عليه السلام ربي قد آتيتني من الملك وعلمتني من تأويل الأحاديث فاطر السماوات والأرض أنت ولي في الدنيا والآخرة توفني مسلما. So Yusuf, Joseph, he was preaching peace because he was a Muslim. Musa was a Muslim and he preached peace because he was a Muslim. قال يا قوم إن كنتم آمنتم بالله فعليه توكلوا إن كنتم مسلمين. Jesus, peace be upon him, was a Muslim and his message was peace because he was a Muslim. What was it? Allah said, فلما أحس عيسى منهم الكفر قال من أنصاري إلى الله قال الحواريون نحن أنصار الله آمنا بالله واشهد بأننا مسلمون. So all the prophets and messengers, their message was peace because they were Muslim. And Allah said to our beloved Prophet Muhammad, the message of peace, the messenger of peace, the symbol of intense and authentic peace, Muhammad. Again, the symbol and the message and the symbol of authentic and intense peace is Muhammad. Because whenever you see peace, you see Muhammad. اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام. So we are what? Peaceful. Because we are Muslims and we are the followers of Muhammad. So all the messengers were Muslim because of what? Because of their peace. They were peaceful, so Allah made them what? They all came with Islam. They were all peaceful because they were Muslim. So when Allah was, look, listen to the greetings of Allah to them. Because they were peaceful, and they were Muslim, they came with Islam. سلام على نوح في العالمين. You hear that? Peace be upon Noah among the worlds. سلام على إبراهيم. Peace be upon who? Ibrahim, because he preached peace and he was a Muslim. سلام على موسى وهارون. Musa and Harun, peace be upon them because they preached peace and they were Muslim. سلام على إلياسين. Peace be upon Elias because he preached peace and he was a Muslim. So the message of Islam is what? Peace. So and to all the messengers and prophets, what did Allah say? سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين. And peace be upon all the messengers. Please, how many times I said peace today? Right now, can you count it? No, because we are peaceful. So we have to educate people. We have to let people understand and we have to prove to people, yes, indeed, we are peaceful because we are Muslims and we are the followers of the messenger of peace, Muhammad. Come on, let's come on. Let's see how we pray. In our prayers, التحيات لله والصلوات والطيبات السلام عليك أيها النبي السلام. You hear that? السلام علينا. You hear that? When we finish, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. You think we will hurt someone? You think Islam will tell you to go and hurt someone? The religion that is preaching and promoting and advising and commanding and ordering people to be peaceful, you think that religion will tell you to go and hurt someone? No. So we are Muslim. We are followers of the Prophet Muhammad. That's why we are peaceful. And we will prove to the whole world that yes, indeed, we are peaceful because we follow Muhammad and he is our role model and he is our instructor, he is our messenger, and he is our prophet. Allah said, Allah said in Surah Al-Nur, فَإِذَا دَخَلْتُمْ بُيُوتًا, and when you enter, and if you enter houses, listen to this, Allah said بُيُوتًا. Allah made it indefinite. Allah made it what? Indefinite. Allah did not say if you enter the houses. He didn't say if you enter the house, but he said a house. Meaning it could be what? Any house. If you enter the house of a Muslim, what do you give him? Peace. If you enter the house of a non-Muslim, what do you give him? Peace. So what you say to people? Peace. Salamun alaykum. So that's why Allah said, وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا. And when the ignorance, now listen to this, when the ignorance address you,
وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما.
And when the ignorance address them, you know what they tell them? Peace. This is us. When they address us, what do we say?
Peace. Go.
Where do we learn this from? We learn this from the Prophet of Peace, Muhammad. That's why, listen, on our sick bed, when we are going to die, on our sick bed, when we are going to die, the greetings of the angels to us is peace. At the door of Jannah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I pray that we all meet in Jannah. At the door of Jannah, before they open the door for us to enter, Salamun alaykum tibtum, peace be upon you.
Fadkhuluha khalidin.
In Jannah, when I meet you, our greetings is what? Peace.
إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات يهديهم ربهم بإيمانهم تجري من تحتهم الأنهار في جنات النعيم دعواهم فيها سبحانك اللهم وتحيتهم فيها.
Their greetings in Jannah is salam, peace.
So please, when you hear them saying something, do not feel bad. Educate them. Do not be angry. Educate them. Because if you become angry, they will not listen to you. So, be patient. Advise them. Inform them. Let them know the beauty of Islam. Wherever you go, you are outside, let people understand indeed you are a Muslim because you are respectful. You are peaceful. Yes. Because you are a follower of the messenger of peace. And what's his name? Muhammad. So please, whenever they approach you outside, say peace. Advise them. When they say something, it hurts. Sometimes it's hurt. It hurts. Say peace. Please, do not fight. Do not insult. Do not attack anyone. Just say peace and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect you. Now is the time of the hadith of Tirmizi and Ibn Abbas. He said, يأتي على الناس زمان الصابر فيها الصابر فيهم كالقابض على الجمر. The Messenger of Allah said, a time will come for us that the patient among us on his deed, it's like someone who is holding a fire. Hold on to fire, can you? It's hot, right? It's burning you. This is the time. Sometimes, nowadays, before holding on to our deed, hurts. Why? Because of what you will hear people saying. What you hear people are saying. But let's prove to people that we are not what they think, but rather we are peaceful and we love everybody. We will never harm anyone, and we are not with anyone who will go and harm anyone. We are Muslim because we were advised by Allah, we were advised by our Prophet Muhammad that we should not harm anyone. Inshallah, with this, I will stop. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of you. All of you here, please, do not forget the message, the first message. It was the right of our parents, being dutiful to our parents, that you should respect them, that you should treat them nice, and you promised me that when you go tonight, you will say, I'm sorry to your mom, because you never know when you are going to die. I pray may Allah give all of you long life. May Allah protect you. May Allah bless you. But please, when you go home, tell your mother to forgive you. Tell your father to forgive you. And this is part one. Part two is coming. What is your right upon your father? What is your right upon your mother? And it will be addressed just as we address this. Why? Because we want good relationship between the father and the son and the daughter. So do your part. Give all of us. May Allah forgive us. May Allah protect us. Barakallahu fikum. I think we have questions.
There's a lot of youth here, I want to hear the energy. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi. Sheikh, was that enough energy?
No, not yet.
Not yet. Again, one more time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi. Yes, let's look alive tonight, inshallah. So we're going to do a Q&A session, and then after that, inshallah, there's going to be some snacks. And then, mashallah, the chef, he went hard, right? He went hard on us about listening to our parents and obeying them. But inshallah, next month, it will be the parents' turn. So make sure we bring our parents to that lecture, okay? We make sure we bring our parents to that lecture. Sisters, please be quiet. Please be quiet. So, Chef, the first question is, please be quiet, okay? Let's bring down the energy level. Hey. So, the first question is, what if your parents are not happy that you are fully practicing Islam?
You heard the question? What if your parents are not fully happy because you are practicing what? Okay. Listen to this. Are they Muslim? Yeah, okay. If your father is a Muslim and a good Muslim, he will never be. He will never be unhappy when you are practicing the Islam. But maybe your way of practicing the Islam is what is making him talk. We have to be sincere. Listen to me. Maybe, look, because all your father wants you to be is for you to be good. When people see you, they say, MashaAllah, this is the son of so and so. Please listen to this question, very important question. This is the son of so and so. And he wants to be proud. They say, oh, mashallah, I saw your daughter. May Allah bless her. She was very good. When they say that about his daughter, will he be happy or not? Good. But maybe the way you approach the deen, that's why maybe they are concerned. The way you approach them, the deen. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Yassiru, wa la tu'assiru, bashiru,
وَلَا تُنَفِّرُ. Make things easy on people. Do not make it hard on them. And give people good news, glad tidings. Do not drive people away. Okay? You see, this religion, Islam, is a simple religion. It depends on how you understand it. Or maybe, the way you are doing your Islam, okay, maybe you are challenging him or her. Okay? If you are challenging him or her, maybe he's 40 years old or 50 years old, and you are his daughter. Now he see you, mashallah, you are covered up, you go to the masjid, you read Quran. Maybe the way you approach him, okay, and talk to him, he's doing maybe something that is not approved by the deen, okay? You don't have the right to scream or yell at him or tell him this is wrong direct.
واذكر في الكتاب إبراهيم إنه كان صديقا نبيا.
Let's take example from Ibrahim.
إذ قال لأبيه يا أبت لم تعبد ما لا يسمع ولا يبصر ولا يغني عنك شيئا.
Listen to the word.
يا أبتي.
Oh daddy. Look, this is a word of respect. The way you approach, that's why. If you approach in the wrong way, he will never listen to you. Fir'aun is the number one criminal. إِنَّهُ كَانَ عَالِيًا مِنَ الْمُسْرِفِينَ. But when Musa and Harun, when they were going to him, what did Allah say?
فَقُولَا لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا.
Do not think maybe because you are covered, because you think you go to the masjid, you are in the deen, that your parents are nobody, you know better than them. The way they do their religion is zero.
No. No.
So, no father will feel bad that his daughter or his son is in Allah's way. Okay? So they should not feel that. And they will not feel that. But Allah said in the Quran, you should be nice to your mother and father, but وَإِن جَاهَدَاكَ عَلَىٰ أَن تُشْرِكَ بِهِ مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٌ فَلَا تُتَهُوَ. This one Allah said direct. If they are telling you to do something that is shirk, Allah said, do not obey that. But listen.
وَصَاهِبْهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا.
At the same time, you did not do what they told you to do for the shirk, about the shirk, but still Allah said, respect them, treat them nicely, be dutiful to them, the way you talk to them. See how Ibrahim was talking to his father.
Ya Abati, Ya Abati, Ya Abati, Inni akhafu an yamassaka adhabu min ar-Rahman, fatakuna lish-shaytani waliya. Ya Abati, Ya Abati. Si qala araghibun anta an alihati ya Ibrahim, la in lam tantahi la arjumannaka wahjurni maliya.
What did he say?
Qala salam.
We come back to our topic, right? He said, peace, daddy. I'm sorry. Salam. So maybe it's the way you approach. That's why they are concerned. Okay? But otherwise, no father will feel bad that his son or his daughter is in Allah's way. Because that's why we all gathered here. They allow you to come here today because they want you to listen to the word of Allah. They want you to be in the path of Allah. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy. So please, the person who asked the question, maybe the way you approach the deen, that's why. Take it easy and go slowly, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring understanding between you and your parents. I hope I answered the question.
MashaAllah. So, I'll save them inshallah for part two.
Okay.
The next question is, if you did something to your mother and or your father, and she does not forgive you before she passes away, are you guaranteed Jannah? Or if you pass away before she does, are you guaranteed?
May Allah forgive us all. The second one, if you pass away before her, it's better for you. If you die before her, it's better for you. But she dies before you, you look, listen. You see, this is one of the danger of hurting your mother and father. Imagine you hurt your mother this night, example. And she went to sleep, she was so angry, crying. She went to sleep and she did not wake up the next morning. Will you ever forgive yourself?
No.
Hey, so we have to be careful. We never know. Sudden death is happening now. You see someone right now, in an hour, they say, oh, you remember so and so, he died. How? How? I just met him right now. Yes, he's dead. You met him right now? Yes, he's dead. Let me tell you something. A man died. Anytime I read Surah Al-Qiyamah, most of the time I cry. Why? Because it reminds me of a man. He loves this surah so much. Wherever I go, he said to me, please do not leave without reading this surah in this masjid. Read it. I want to hear it. I love the surah. And the way the surah is describing how a man's soul is taken away from him, that man died just like that. He died just like that. He was in the kitchen, talking to a friend. The friend was cutting tomato. Okay? So he was behind, talking to the friend. And the friend talking to him, talking back. So the friend talked, he did not respond. He was standing. When he turned, I'm talking, he not responding. When he turned, this man is coming on top of him like this. He held him. He laid him down. All he hears, he couldn't talk. Like that. He's gone.
كلا إذا بلغت التراقي وقيل من راق وظن أنه الفراق والتفت الساق بالساق إلى ربك.
Just the way the surah telling us how the soul is removed from the body, he died like that. So when I read the surah, I always remember him. Why am I bringing this up? Because of sudden death. He woke up in the morning healthy, just talking to his friend, and he's gone. So imagine you hurt your mother or your father. He goes to bed, and he dies. Who is going to forgive you that time? It's dangerous. Look. Why is it dangerous? You can keep saying astaghfirullah, doing good things, but you are not sure if he's forgiven or not. But if he's alive, if you die, it's better for you. He was about to die. You couldn't say la ilaha illallah. And he was a good person. He was a good man. He was a companion of the Prophet Muhammad. So they went and told the Prophet, this man is a good man. He's always praying behind you. He's going to die now. We tell him to say, la ilaha illallah. He couldn't say it. The messenger said, where is his mother? Look, the first question, where is his mother? They called her. Say, your son is about to die. He's dying. We want him to say, la ilaha illallah, but he's not responding. What happened? What's going on? Is she the one dying? But the messenger asked her. She said, no, he's a good person. He's a good man. He goes to the masjid. But the Prophet said, but what? She said, but. She said, but what? Talk. She doesn't want to talk. The Messenger of Allah said, okay, no problem. Since you don't want to talk, we're going to start with the thing that is going to fill over there. Bring the fire. Come, set fire on him. Let's see. Because he's going to be burned anyway when he dies. So let's start from here. And he wasn't going to do that, but he wanted to see something. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa ma arsalnaka illa rahmatan lil alameen. So when they brought the firewood and everything, they started picking the fire. They wanted to throw him inside. She said, no, stop. The thing he did is that since he married, I see that he loves his wife more than me. And that is hurting me because I'm his mother. I carried him in my womb for 9 months. I suffered a lot. And now he is showing me that I'm nobody. This is the only thing he's doing. And he did. So that's why he wouldn't say La ilaha illallah. And it's not that he's insulting her. Just that she thinks he's showing his wife so much love and he's forgetting her. Maybe he will go and buy chicken for his wife and everything for her. She has to eat the rice without chicken. Example. Because he did not insult her directly, did he? No. But he was doing something that it was hurting her. So imagine the one who said to my mom, leave me alone. Whatever. Some of you do that, right? Tell your mom, whatever. Talking over your mom so she can talk. Yeah, be careful. So the good one is, let you die before your mom. Because if she see you going, she will say, oh Allah, all that she did to me, I forgive her. But if she die or he dies before you, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. May Allah protect us all. So please be dutiful to your parents. And if you go tonight, I repeat, please say I'm sorry. Please forgive me and pray for me. I promise I will do my best not to hurt you anymore. Please do that.
We have two more questions, right? Okay, so as long as the chef is loud, we laugh. The next question is, how do you deal with a mother who is a people believer? Someone who cares too much about what people think and doesn't try to understand you. So you want to elaborate on that question? I feel you my young people, I know, because I grew up in that era. So basically, you know, when you,
like what does she believe in? What?
Basically, when you go outside and they say, hey, Lincoln, I see such and such today. I seen your son or your daughter doing this, that, and the third. And then they go back and tell the parents, and then, you know, the parents say, so, Lincoln, not cutting your
hair. Is the thing they saw there, yeah, they saw you doing outside is good or bad?
I guess it's probably bad.
So start doing the bad thing and they will not say it.
Probably they're assuming.
They're assuming.
So
in the back of the day.
Basically spying or assuming.
Okay. Well, Alhamdulillah. Okay. This is the answer right here. If it is bad, you yourself know is bad, then stop. And no one will go and tell your mom. If you see someone goes and tell your mom of you doing something bad, he loves you. If they don't love you, they don't care. It's not my son, go ahead. But if they go, and one thing you have to understand, we are Africans, we have something we call culture. Some of our culture is not contradicting the deen. So any Islamic culture that is not contradicting the deen, it is accepted in Islam. And this kind of culture, we live, look, Africans, the way we live, my father, someone in our area, he's not my family, he can punish me for doing wrong. And my father will go and say, thank you. But it's now that the culture is, if somebody touch your son, he goes and say, yeah, you know his father? You know his mother, why would he do healing? Africa, they don't heed to hurt, but they heed to teach and to make sure you grow up to become a good person. So this, we were punished, but some people that are not our family. Let me tell you something. I was punished so badly, my grandmother, may Allah forgive her. Yeah, I love her so much. I even named my daughter Amina because of her. I did something in the house. It was not good. I think she, what is it? I forgot. Well, it wasn't good anyway. So, and I said, I'm sorry, but she wanted me to be punished. Why? Because it was not good. I forgot exactly, maybe if I remember, I will tell you. She took me to the teacher, my teacher, may Allah bless him. I learned Quran from him, so I will never forget him in my life. She said, Sheikh, please, he's sorry, please don't hit him, don't punish him, because she already told him to punish me. So I said, please go and tell him not to punish me. He goes, he's going to beat me a lot. She said, okay, let's go. She loved me so much. The day I finished the Quran, she was crying in the masjid. She wore all white, you know how all white, and she cooked a lot of food. All the teachers in the masjid, she bought them garments, white. And she was crying in the masjid. I was so embarrassed. I said, hey, none of the parents cry. Why are you crying? You know, she loved me, she loved me, she loved me so, so much. So when she told him not to punish me, I said, okay. I thought I was fine. My friends told me when she was leaving, she gave me, said, go ahead. So when she left, I sat down, he said, come here. I said, okay, come for what again? He punished me for that. Why am I saying this? In Africa, they punish you just because they want you to be good. And today, alhamdulillah, due to that punishment, okay, I am obeying, or I am in the path of Allah, and I pray may Allah accept it. So, listen, if you know what you are doing is bad, then stop. They will not go and say it. And also, if it is done, okay, they think you are doing something bad. Because I don't think they will see you walking nicely, or maybe you dress nicely, walking outside, they go and tell your mom, I saw your daughter half naked outside. Or I saw your son with his pants all the way down. You understand? They will not do that. I don't think anyone will do that. Okay? But if they assume, maybe they will know, maybe you were doing bad, you try to let your mother understand, but in a good way. Try to talk to them. Believe me, what they are saying, I did not do it. Maybe they were thinking that, but I wasn't doing that. And try to prove into your mom that you are not that bad person that those people were talking about. Okay? But it shouldn't be any fight. And do not insult those people and tell them hypocrites. No, they are the friends and family of your peers.
So kids, you know, I'm on your side. I was trying to help you out. I know how that feels, you know. But just make sure y'all be good out there.
That's it.
Chef, this one is a little touching. You know, and especially in America, a lot of kids is brought up without their father in their life. So this question is kind of like that. So it says, what if your father is not in your life? Does he still deserve your love if you guys cross paths again?
Why is he not in your life?
Why is he not?
First question.
Well, that's...
Why is he not in your life?
I'm assuming, I guess he left your life when he was little, or you know, when he was little.
Okay.
Divorce?
May Allah forgive us.
Yeah. Okay. Or doesn't want to be a part of the kid's life growing.
And you, do you see him? You go to him and he tell you go?
Yeah, because he said, does he still deserve your love if you guys cross paths?
Okay. Cross paths, subhanAllah. May Allah make this easy. Okay. Can I advise you? Can I advise you? Thank you. And who is our role model? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Allah said, وَلَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا. He is a good example that we should follow. It hurts. It hurts that your mother of your father will not be in your life. If he's not here, he's in Africa or something like that, it's understood. But if you see him, first, why is he staying away from you? He should not. Because you are his blood, you are his son, you are his daughter. So he should be in your life, help you, advise you, so that you will grow up and become a good person. But if still he says no, you, what you have to do, your part is that wherever you see him, you will greet him. Hey, listen to this. Your part, you will do your part. Wherever you see him, say, Assalamu alaikum, Daddy. If you are going to do something, or you are going somewhere, you need his permission, even if he's not going to answer, do your part. Call him and say, I just want to tell you, I will be going so and so place. He said, So, okay, assalamu alaikum, hamdulillah. When you see him, assalamu alaikum. Why? And where do we get this from? Allah said, وَإِن جَاهَدَكَ أَلَىٰ أَن تُشْرِكَ بِهِ مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٌ فَلَا تُطِئْهُمَا وَصَاحِبُهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا. Listen, all that your dad is doing to you, that is not listening to you, and it's not in your life, all this is not bigger than shirk. Is it bigger than shirk? No. Do you know what a shirk is? Do you know that if you die without asking Allah for forgiveness, He's not going to forgive you for shirk? إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. If you commit, look, shirk, and you did not ask Allah for forgiveness, and you die, Allah said He will never forgive you. So now, see how big the shirk is? Allah said, even if he is mushrik, or he is telling you to go and do shirk, do not listen to him on that, but still obey him. Say salam to him. Be nice to him. Be dutiful to him. If you get something, give it to him. Why? Because you want Allah to love you. You are not doing it for him, but you are doing it for who? For Allah. Please. So do never cross paths. And your dad is not saying salam to you, and you too say, whatever. It's not saying salam to me. I'm not going to say salam to him too. No. Say salam. He is your father. No matter what happened, he is your father. You cannot get any father anywhere. Whoever claims that he is your father, believe me, he will never be better than your father. Because same blood is running in both your veins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us.
Inshallah, Chef, this one is also another tough one here. But we gotta keep going because the kids wanna learn. Does the same sin applies to you? No, does the same sin applies to your step parents, even if they're bad to you?
Your step parents. Okay. So if I say you say your step parent, that means maybe your mother's husband. He's not your father. Thank you.
Or the vice versa.
Good. Or the other, yeah. Okay, your step. Now, your stepfather is in a place of your father, even if your father is alive, because he is married to your mother. So the same respect you give your father, you will give it to him for the sake of your mother. For the sake of your mother. And in Islam, even if he's not your father, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he is not among us. The one who does not respect the grown-ups, the adults, and the one who is not having mercy on the young ones. Okay? So having mercy on the young ones and also respecting the adults, the grown-ups. So even if he's not your father, Allah said you should respect him because of his age. And look, so now his age, at the same time he is your mother's husband, okay, or she is your father's wife, okay, you should respect them. Do your best and do your part and leave the rest for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But you should respect them as you respect your father.
So, one more question. Okay, I think you... It's not. I think you already answered this question about... Because you talked about your grandmother, but I'm going to answer it anyway. Is disrespecting your grandmother the same as disrespecting your mother?
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. 100%. Yes. You don't disrespect your grandmother. If you respect your mother, then you will respect your grandmother. Okay? Yeah. Yes, it is. This is the only answer I give. Yes. Yes, it is. If you disrespect her, it's like you disrespecting your mother.
Playing where people play with the grandmother, yeah. That's all over African culture stuff. Okay. Like that. So, I mean, is that you know, consider as disrespectful.
No, playing and joking around. That one is a culture that if you do it, then make sure you don't overdo it or do not insult. I grew up with my grandmother, like I said. She was strict and sometimes, and at the same time, we play. But when it's time for me to do what I'm supposed to do, maybe go to school or go to my Quran teacher to learn, and if I don't do it, the whole area will hear me. I have to leave my room and run. Okay? But at the same time, we joke around. She called me her husband. She said my husband. And you know, they joke around like that. So you joke, but make sure you don't say something that is going to hurt them. You have to always try to make sure you watch your language. Yeah, the way you address them. Okay, you talk to them. But playing around, and because sometimes they call the boys our husbands, and they call our grandfathers call the girls my wife. Okay? Yes, this is African culture that they do playing around, you know, play with your jokes, with your grandparents, but at the same time, you should not disrespect them. You should not insult them.
Okay. Back to the chef for him to conclude it. Future leaders of Islam would like to thank you all for coming. Inshallah, for 2017, we will have a monthly lecture. So please don't come alone. Also invite your parents, especially the next topic that we're gonna have, which is children's right upon parents.
Very important topic. Please come.
So it's gonna be on February 25th, the last Saturday of February, inshallah. Please come early. Please bring more people. Mashallah, I didn't expect this much people to come, but alhamdulillah, you guys showed up. So please, we urge you to bring more people. Inshallah.
Alhamdulillah. So, my brothers and sisters, barakallahu fikum, may Allah bless all of you. You heard the message. The first message is to be dutiful to our parents. Like we said, the children have rights upon their children, and also the parents have rights upon their children. Inshallah, we discussed this today. Our next inshallah is going to be your rights upon your parents. But inshallah, I want to try to bring your mother and father, inshallah, so we can do justice to the topic. I pray may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make things easy. May Allah bless all of you. And also be tolerant. When you go outside, be nice to people. Let them understand, educate them. Let them know you are good Muslims. May Allah bless all of you. May Allah protect you. Allahumma ahdina fi man hadayt, wa afina fi man afayt, wa tawallana fi man tawallayt, wa barik lana fi ma atayt, wa qina sharra ma qadayt. Allahumma ahdina wa ahdi bina wa ja'alna sababan liman ihtada, alladhina qala lahum an-nas inna an-nas qad jama'u lakum fakhshahum fazadahum imana, wa qalu hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel, hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel, hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel, fanqalabu bi ni'mati minallahi wa fadlin lam yamsasuhum su'. واتبرد الله والله ذو فضل عظيم وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على عبدك ونبيك محمد وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين سبحان ربك رب العزه عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين الحمد لله رب العالمين
ان شاء الله الله عز وجل reward all of us together and make us those who will listen and obey ان شاء الله just few announcements for the youngsters the brothers ان شاء الله tomorrow we're gonna have a halaqa ان شاء الله make sure you attend جزاكم الله خيرا And also, there's a class that is going on here. 3 days classes, right? 3 days classes, inshallah. The sisters can attend for the lesson that comes on Akhdari. So, inshallah, that class is on Wednesday, right? If I'm not mistaken, huh? Okay. 5 to 7. For the sisters, you make wudu. When you wudu, when you have a mistake on your wudu, how to correct it. So please go to the class. For the brothers, Monday and Tuesday, right? Monday and Tuesday, you take Arabic and Hadith. So,